The latest survey on Cook Inlet beluga whales subpopulation occurred in 2018, with the report being released in 2020. Scientists estimated that the population size is between 250 and 317, with a median estimate of 279, and is down from the 2016 estimate of 328 animals. Over the last 10 years, from 2008 to 2018, the population has been declining at minus 2.3% per year. In fact, the population has declined by nearly 80% since 1979, from about 1,300 whales to the estimated 279 whales in 2018. Belugas are found in Arctic and subarctic waters, and five distinct populations have been identified. Each population is unique and is isolated either genetically, physically, or both, by migration routes and their preferred habitats. Cook Inlet belugas live in south central Alaska in Cook Inlet, which is a very murky inlet containing a lot of silt from glacial streams and rivers. At the top of Cook Inlet is Anchorage, Alaska's largest population center with 300,000 people. All belugas are protected under the Marine Mammal Protection Act, but in 2008, the Cook Inlet subpopulation was listed as endangered under the Endangered Species Act. Aerial surveys have been conducted by NOAA Fisheries annually or biannually since 1993, and the next one was due in June 2020, but I'm not sure if that took place due to the coronavirus pandemic. Either way, it takes a while to process all the data and get it published, so the results wouldn't be available for about another year. All other populations of belugas, other than the Cook Inlet ones, have thousands of whales. For example, the Eastern Chukchi Sea Stock has 20,752 individuals, and the Bristol Bay population has around 1,926 individuals, and numbers are rising. So why is it that the Cook Inlet population is faring so badly? Subsistence hunting by the Tubakana tribe took place for thousands of years, and they have traditionally used beluga for clothing, shelter, heating, as well as a food resource. In the 1930s, commercial hunting also occurred, and sport hunting occurred in the 1960s. The hunting by non-Alaska natives was finally banned in 1972 when the Marine Mammal Protection Act was passed. In 1979, the population was estimated to be at 1,300 and was considered healthy and at the carrying capacity of the area. But as Anchorage's population grew in the 1990s and Cook Inlet became more accessible to outside communities, subsistence take of Cook Inlet belugas increased, and it is believed that this was the most significant cause of their decline. In 2005, the Tubakana tribe and other Alaska natives of Cook Inlet voluntarily ended their subsistence hunt of belugas. It was hoped that the population would begin to recover, but it has not, and the belugas were declared endangered in 2008. Once a species is listed as endangered, NOAA Fisheries is required to determine whether there are any areas that meet the definition of a critical habitat. A critical habitat is a habitat needed to support the recovery of a listed species. In May 2011, two areas of critical habitat were declared. The total area is 7,809 square kilometres. The first area covers Upper Cook Inlet and Kachemak Bay. The second area is the nearshore waters along the west coast of Lower Cook Inlet. In 2015, NOAA Fisheries announced a five-year program to focus their efforts to protect eight species that are currently among the most at risk of extinction in the near future, one of these being the Cook Inlet beluga whales. This five-year action plan focuses on certain priority actions for the Cook Inlet beluga whale, which are to continue to improve the understanding of why Cook Inlet beluga whales are not recovering by enhancing the stranding response program, reduce anthropogenic noise that may disrupt feeding or breeding, protect habitats that support foraging or reproduction from other anthropogenic and natural threats, gain a better understanding of population characteristics to ensure effective management actions result in recovery, and finally, ensure healthy and plentiful prey are available. But the numbers of Cook Inlet beluga whales continue to decline, and no one really understands why. Although scientists do have some ideas, they need further study. In 2021, NOAA announced another five-year programme to focus and redouble their efforts for the beluga whales of Cook Inlet. One of the hypotheses as to why the whales are not recovering is that Cook Inlet is just too noisy for them, having many sources of anthropogenic noise. It has passenger and cargo jets landing at Anchorage. Also, a railroad runs along the coast of the inlet. There are also many container ships on the move in and out of the port at Anchorage, delivering food and consumer goods. As well as all of this, there is a huge oil and gas industry in the Cook Inlet Basin. In the summer of 2019, NOAA authorised more oil and gas activities in the area, which are dependent on the results of seismic surveys. The surveys could only occur at certain times and require mitigation activities, such as monitoring to detect marine mammals before a beginning and shutting down activities under certain circumstances to minimise injury of marine mammals. Understandably, there has been an outcry from conservation groups, and the Centre for Biological Diversity has even sued NOAA, saying that it is in violation of the Endangered Species Act protecting the belugas. Unfortunately, the response of NOAA was that the limitations and provisions issued to the oil company are the most appropriate way to protect marine mammals, which seems to be at odds with one of the points given in the five-year plan of reducing anthropogenic noise. Luckily, once it got to court, the judge rejected the authorisation given to the gas and oil company for exploration activities, citing potential negative impacts to the beluga population. The problem with anthropogenic noise is that it interferes with the whale's echolocation, used to find food, to navigate, and makes communication with each other difficult, particularly between mother and calves. And bearing in mind that the waters are very silty, their ability to echolocate is even more important to them. Amongst all this sad news, I found something I thought was very uplifting. That is the Alaska Beluga Monitoring Partnership. It offers the greatest citizen science project I've ever seen. The citizen science monitoring started in 2008 and has evolved into what it is today, with the formation of the Alaska Beluga Monitoring Partnership in 2019. There are two monitoring seasons, in the autumn from August the 15th until November the 15th, and spring from March the 15th to May the 15th. There are daily monitoring sessions, which last around 2 hours, and are scheduled around the tide for when belugas are known to be in the area. The monitoring takes place from the shore at various sites throughout Cook Inlet. The information that is collected will help provide researchers, managers, and the public with valuable information. To take part, you need to complete a volunteer orientation and at least one training session with a lead observer out in the field. Once you are confident you know what you're doing, you are good to do it on your own. Again, as with many of the other animals or habitats I have written about, there are many people working hard to save these beautiful creatures. And if you live near Cook Inlet or can time a vacation for one of these monitoring seasons, you too could take part in gathering vital information to help save these amazing whales. Guess what I've just added to my bucket list? If you enjoyed this video, then please like, subscribe, and share with your like-minded friends.